been 24 hours since Facebook unfriended Aussie News in a very, very public way.
Facebook is fighting back against the Australian government.
Shock decision to block news content.
Australia wants social media giants to pay for the content.
Wowzers is all I can say.
And we're doing just fine.
It's not okay to unfriend Australia because Australia's very friendly.
I'm going to shirt front Mr. Putin.
I would just say to Facebook, this is Australia. You want to do business here? You work according to our rules.
That's right. If Mark Zuckerberg thinks we can be bullied into submission, he is wrong. And FYI, Zuck, our main man Morrison has been in touch with his international counterparts.
I was speaking to Narendra Modi yesterday because I've spoken to President Macron. I've had these exchanges with Prime Minister Trudeau and Prime Minister Johnson. People are looking at what Australia is doing.
More than that, US and UK officials have openly condemned the move.
This bully boy action that they've undertaken in Australia will, I think, ignite a desire to go further amongst legislators around the world.
While France, Germany, Finland, Spain and Canada are actively working on laws to make Facebook pay for news. It's obviously got the media world in a tiz too, but the
very friendly
people of Australia, they're a little more torn.
Yeah, they should. Users should pay. Journalists should be paid for their work. Absolutely.
I think it should be free.
I think Facebook should back down.
Maybe I can get rid of Facebook as well.
Facebook pulled the plug on news in Australia in retaliation to our government's plan to make them and Google pay for it. Facebook said Australia just doesn't get social media and reckons it was doing our news outlets a favour, letting them share their content with millions of eyes around the world.
Facebook's position is that it's adding value to publishers and therefore requiring it to compensate publishers actually is double dipping.
Facebook bosses reckon they generated more than $400 million worth of clicks for Aussie News last year. But they also say journalism only counts for 4% of what users see. So it's no skin off their nose if there's no more of this quality content. So do we need to kiss and make up, or is it time to make a clean break?
Because Australia's very friendly. We'd like to remain very friendly, and it's time for them to friend us again.
Crikey, political editor Bernard Keane joins us now. Where do we start with this, Bernard? I suppose with the idea that news content does add value to Facebook and the product that Facebook offers. So given that, isn't it fair to ask them to pay for it?
Well, that's the response to that's pretty divided. On the one hand, media companies and the government reckon that news content's enormously valuable to both Google and Facebook, and, you know, they're stealing it in effect, so why shouldn't they pay for it? If you ask Facebook, they've got a very different take. They say that news content actually forms a very small part of the content that Australians put on Facebook, so the value is actually pretty limited.
Bernard, won't this do wonders for news websites because people will go to that specific site?
Well, it depends on the website, because if you're a small website like, Crikey, or specialist sites or youth-oriented news sites like Junkie.com, the closure of Facebook's immensely problematic because Facebook's a key kind of vector for disseminating your content. You know, you're looking for subscribers like we are at Crikey, or you're a free media outlet that relies on advertising. That lack of the Facebook page becomes really, really crucial in terms of cutting off both your way of raising revenue and your way of accessing new eyeballs to try and sell your product to.
So, OK, it seems like everybody involved in this is unhappy with the situation. The tech companies are unhappy with it. The media companies aren't particularly thrilled with it. And users literally right now are losing out. So sketch it out for me. What would a better policy from the government actually look like then?
I reckon a better policy would be, we need more money out of the tech giants. They don't pay enough tax. So the likes of Google and Facebook and other tech companies like Apple, they should be paying a lot more tax and use that to put more money into public interest journalism.
Who do you think will fold first, Facebook or the government?
Well, a really tough question. Look, there's a couple of schools of thought. One is, look, Facebook's incurred massive reputational damage and they're going to fold pretty quickly. But on the other hand, Facebook is so enormous that the revenues from Australia are, as one of its former executives put it, a rounding error for that company. So they may take the view that they don't need to fold, they don't need to do anything. They can just sit back and watch us swing in the breeze, because the money that they make from Australia just isn't that significant.
And if Facebook were to fold, other countries look at it, I mean, then it ceases to be a rounding error potentially. That's, I suppose, the issue, Bernard.
Well, that's the thing. I mean, If they let a precedent be established, that's when it becomes a much more significant financial issue for Facebook. Yeah.
I'll have their rounding error, by the way, if they're looking at throwing that money away. We're going to go.
No, me too.
Bernard, thank you very much for joining us. Appreciate it.
Thanks very much.
This is such a complicated one because the legislation is imperfect, but at the same time, for years, we know that Facebook have viewed news content as being valuable. They've actively encouraged news outlets to fill basically their feed with content because it basically added value to the news feed. It was one of the reasons why people would go to the news feed is to see news, whether they were actively searching for it or not. So we know it was valuable to them, maybe not in revenue, but in terms of things to keep people on the platform. But at the same time, maybe news media organisations should never have done that deal where they're basically ceding their entire business to a third-party company that they have no control over. So if nothing else, hopefully this means that people that make news, and it's hard work doing news properly, they own that relationship with, well, literally with you, the viewer, as opposed to letting it go through another company.
With so much content online, it's sometimes hard to keep up with it all. And let's face it, who has the time? The project YouTube has you covered with the stories that matter. Hit subscribe for a daily list of the news that you need to know.